Since okay, since we reloaded, I cannot move my character, please.
No, I can't move mine either. I think we should talk to the dude here, Farzo.
Yeah, definitely.
Hi. Are you alright? Warm in there. Dog's been out. Okay.
That's not me. That's not me. Someone else moved my car.
Oh, you cannot make this action while the game is currently paused.
What are you doing with us, huh? Sorry. Yeah, listen, I missed that. You know, it's massive letters, you know, in bold. Sorry. I was like, oh, why can't I move?
We're having a good time tonight, yeah.
Yeah, everyone is still alive, so it's good. Is there a kitchen at the back where I can do some work? Pay for my lodging.
Pardon? It's in the freezer. Okay. I'm just swapping to push the talk. Sorry about that.
We require lodgings and food for the evening, if that's okay.
And drinks. I raise my hand above.
Hello, Fazo. I'm Balak. These are my compadres, Cosimo and Jalhhan. We would require lodgings, please, for the evening, at the very least. How long did...
I can afford it, that's good. How about drinks and food, please? Okay, I turn to Bala, you know, I mean, I can't read. Can you read this, please?
Can't read?
I'm joking. I'm making it up, okay? I can read, so just play with me, all right?
Okay. So, yeah, we'll...
Venison sounds good. And any beer or ale or something. Okay, so I play stupid. I pull out my 5 silver. That's all the money I have. And I hand it to, you know, Mala and ask, is this enough for it? I don't know. Is that all? Oh, okay, cool. Okay, let's find the table.
I need to press 2 now.
Should we move to
the... I say to Farzo, why are you charging him full price? It's only half a person. It should only cost him like half a silver.
I banged my head from him.
Yes, food please. 2 adults and a child portion.
I want a full portion, not child portion. I like my stomach. And I gave enough money for a full portion.
we seem to be getting any kind of unwanted attention.
Okay.
Well, everybody seems cool.
What do they do, Phil? I mean, is any of them eating, playing some cards, or they're just drinking? Can you? So no one is playing any games. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay. I like to. I mean, we are waiting for food. I like to bring out my dice set, and you know, ask my companions if anyone wanna play. And basically, I'm trying to get the attention of other people from other tables. I don't know if. Okay. I think I can overcome this problem with my bad dexterity. I like to not throw away one of my dice accidentally into the main room, so I can go and pick it up. So everyone, I mean, I'm trying to make a commotion when everyone pays attention to me. What the heck I'm picking up from the floor? I'm trying to bait them. Okay. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm really clumsy. I mean, do you good at the dice? I seem to be, you know, not so good. I look around tactically, you know, like, is she around? I can't see her. Okay, so you're not interested? All right, I respect your, you know, motions. Oh, so they're all poor. Okay, listen. Yeah. Okay, before. Sorry. Okay, so while we are having this conversation with this fine gentleman,
I went over there. Before you was even talking about this dude being shady, I came over because I thought he was going to play cards, so I went and sat at his table. But I was waiting for Cosmo to finish his dice thing.
So, so basically what I'm doing, I will ask the name of this gentleman who I spoke to with the heavily repaired clothing. I'm asking him, what's his name? I'm asking him. I introduce myself and I ask him, what's your name? I'm just trying to be friendly. Sorry? I just wanted to your name. So I was going to walk to the bar and, you know, send you a beer. But without your name, how do I do that? Okay, everyone is fine. I turn around and walk back to my table. Yeah, these people are crazy. The locals are. Alright. I walk back to the table and play with the dice on my own. No one wanna play with me. Fine. I hand back the change, okay? You can keep it. I want a good report here. So.
What's wrong with their fields?
I don't know. I'm no farmer. Go and ask them. I'm no farmer. That if it's overgrown by wheat, because they don't tend them, or what is it? Or they don't have manpower, or what's going on? Actually, I indicate to that girl who served us, and you know, I ask her back to the table. I guess she would react to my request, would she? And I ask her these questions. You know, I'm just curious about what's going on around here with the farms and land. Would you care to explain for us, please? Do they know the... Okay, do they know the reason for this? I lean forward and ask her, like whispering, is it a curse? I love with her, you know. All right, thank you very much. You know, see you soon. After she leaves, I turn to my companions. Definitely a curse. So you might want to check the food, because we might get poisoned, robbed, or who knows what. What's in the books for us, you know? You never know what's coming around the corner. Eat and drink. Have fun.
Yeah, eat and drink, and then shall we talk to this dude over here?
I whisper a little bit, you know, I mean, just thinking out loud. Maybe she's busy upstairs.
Did she say, you said that she was going to meet us in a couple of days, but is she supposed to be meeting us today? What, today?
If I would just check if she's been here already.
Yeah, can I go and ask, Fonzie, if he knows about her. Fonzo.
The Fonz. Yeah, so.
Hey, Farzo. Yeah, that's all right. Do you know where my sister's going to arrive? Has she booked a room here? Her name is...
Thredony.
Freddy.
Oh.
Well, what do you mean by lady? She's my sister.
No, she's not.
Lily has to repeat at the same time.
Does it always rain here? Okay, because it's been raining on my screen for like all the time we've been here. Okay, can I have a flag and an ale?
Oh,
whatever, I'll just take like two gold coins out and just put them on the bar and then ask for a flagon of ale. I'm not allowed to stab him, am I? For not selling me what I want. Dan, what do you think we should do? Should we talk to this other dude?
We have nothing better to do. Why not? He might want to play that, you know.
Have we gave word? Sorry, I was just pointing dog out. Have we gave word to the innkeeper that we were expecting someone and that if she comes to let us know?
Yeah, he insulted my sister and then wouldn't sell me a flagon of ale.
Right,
I'm not hard to believe. Yeah.
Cultivate lady. You know what she you know what Freddy's like.
Not sure I do. But we will let cooler heads prevail and yeah. I'll drag you off by your ear before you get your ass beat up by an innkeeper. And we will just have a discussion regarding what to do next. We're going to wait for her. This guy in the corner looks like he's out of place. We can maybe talk to him, hustle him, if Cosimo's trying to steal money from people.
No, Cosimo doesn't want to steal from these people.
Sounds like trying to hustle the poor people, to be honest.
Yeah, they are very poor. I don't want to, rob them, I mean, I have morals, okay?
All of a sudden, your alignment's coming to play, isn't it?
No, I mean, I will rob someone else or steal or something.
Yeah,
maybe,
so...
But who says I do steal? How do you know that, huh?
So the lay of the land is, this place is shit poor. There's something not quite right with the crops, and we're waiting for Thredney here. We're not going to pick a fight with a person that's putting us up overnight.
Oh, no, I was only joking about that. Cosmo, are you a bard, did you say?
Yes, I am.
Why don't you play him some music, see if you can cheer him up?
I hate music.
But don't bards play music?
All the moms around.
I'm not a common bard, I'm Cosimo.
A cousin?
No, Cosimo. That's my name. I'm not a bard, I'm Cosimo the bard. I'm not like other bards. I hate music.
It's okay, it's weird, just let it fly, it's fine.
I show you my, instrument with the...
You can keep your instrument, I don't need to see it.
No, not that one, you Muppet. The big one, with the cut strings, they are curling back and... Look at it, how can I play it? Someone murdered my instrument and, I cannot get over it. So now I use it to smash knees and heads. Instead of
playing. About which so is it the guy sat here on his own on this table? Okay. I'll ask Farzo just on the slide said we're not the other ones that look out of place in here tonight. What's that guy's deal? Got it. he a regular or is he? Is he? Okay. I'll drop him a copper piece and then just walk away. I'll approach Garrett. Friendly chat. Obviously not going to get one of them here tonight, am I? Good. Are these cards that are set in front of you? Barkeep tells me your name's Garrett. You also look out to play safe tonight. What brings you into this shithole?
I like this guy.
Cool. Good talk. Catch you on the flip side. And I will leave him alone and just keep an eye on him. I'm going to position me somewhere I can see the majority of the bar fill. Including that the weirdo.
You've got the problem. My friend just asked you, was being friendly to you, and you told him to fuck off. I'm not talking to you, and I'm just stood here, next to the fire, warming myself, admiring the cat.
So,
cup of ale, please.
I'd like to ask a question for you, please. This fine gentleman, you know, with the very bad manners, you know. Oh, sorry. So this fine gentleman, you know, with the very bad manners, is his clothing. Can you describe it again, please? How about his boots? Okay, cool. Well, that's fine. I just wanted to make an observation. Thank you. I think we should retire for the night.
I brought you beers.
Good, thank you. Let's drink it.
I say to Balak, that dude shifty. Cosmo, go and sit under this table and see if he notices.
You think people can't see me because I'm half the size or what?
Oh no, I know that you're like, you're visible, but because you are short of stature, I'm just going to take the mick out of it the whole time.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, that's fine, sorry. I took you seriously, told me I'm invisible or something. All right. No, I mean, he lacks manners, you know, he was very
good
to you.
And to, you know, dance correct, yes.
Show me your dice game.
Yeah, sure. I'll bring out my dice set and we can play. I mean, we play money. It's always money, okay? We don't play for entertainment. We play for, you know, getting rich. Okay?
Yeah, that's cool.
One of us gonna get rich, one of us gonna get poor, and it's usually it's I'm the rich man. Okay. Just a warning.
The fire's gone out.
So, do you wanna play? Let's play on one silver piece.
Hey, that dude's gone as well.
It's not our concern, is it?
Where did he leave?
I don't know. I asked the, keeper, he might know. But why are you interested about that guy? You think he's trouble?
No, I was just trying to make friends.
He's no friend of anyone.
Where you go now?
So, I bring out my dice set, Phil, and we play. I cheat. I blatantly cheat. Okay, I like to use slay of them.
Yeah, that's okay. Because what we're gonna do is we're gonna make out that you're really bad, and then these people might want to play with you.
Yeah, actually, that's not bad. Okay, I try to cheat to lose. Okay, but listen, these people, they have no money. They just said to us. So what's the point doing that?
Shall we retire for the night and see what happens in the morning?
Yeah. I need rich customers, not these poor, souls. It's no point to rob them. That's below even me. No.
So, Phil, why are we all drawn together? I know why we're here. We're here meeting Fionnbrun or whatever she wants to call.
I came because I'm looking to try and find a talking sword and a dragon, but that's my own personal agenda.
I think it's maybe something we could hammer out right now, just quick chat.
Yeah, Balak, what's your profession? You're a ranger, aren't you?
I'm a bounty hunter.
Ah, so we could know each other, and maybe we went off in search for Cosimo. Maybe we had a bounty on him because he kept cheating people, but we kind of liked him. Yeah. Or we're taking him somewhere.
Yeah, I kind of like that, Amy. I suppose that works.
Because, like, even though I'm a fighter, I'm not. I learned the martial adapt because I went. I was like sent to a monastery to learn it or something. Maybe I met Cosimo there. Maybe he was like. I don't know Cosmo's backstory. Cosimo, what's your backstory?
Yeah. I'm here. I'm listening. My backstory. I was born and lived on the streets. And I made fortune there, and I lost fortune there. I had, girls, and I lost girls there. And I made some kind of powerful enemy, which I don't want to discuss yet. And the consequence is my flute, my lute, what you can see here. And, I am suffering from PTSD at the moment because of this. And it's going back for a couple of years now, so I'm not a happy man. Halfling.
Yeah, that's cool. Shall we see if there's any wanted people around here to entertain ourselves while we're waiting for my sister to turn up? What type of law? Is there a type of law? Is there a gatehouse or something like that here? So the farms are like just spread out. It's not like a village or a settlement type of thing. I don't think much to this pub. I think we should. I don't know what this dude was doing.
Well, I reckon
so you're a bounty hunter and I'm a fighter and Cosmo's a bard with PTSD that doesn't like music.
Yes, that's correct. Sounds like the ideal party.
How about this? How about you hired me to bring, help you find a sister who's supposed to meet you in this pub?
Right.
Okay, cool.
So are we an adventuring party?
So how about, you know, before...
I have the nobles looking for a better life.
Yeah. How about, you know, to tie our backstory together? Yeah, so, you know, we know each other for years, and you knew my old personality, and I was happy and playing music and all this shit, and now, you know, because it has changed, you feel pity for me, because, you know, I'm not happy anymore, and you think... might be able to turn this around in the future, maybe not, who knows, and they just don't want to leave me alone because of this thing. You know, I'm no noble, you know, I'm a cheeky bugger, but you know, we used to be proper friends. Now you just all feel sorry for me.
How about this? How about as an old favorite to the noble family, I'm bodyguarding these crazy kids on their crazy adventure, and they're bringing their person McNugget along for a ride.
Sure, that could work as
or we could have all grown up together and went our separate ways, but then there's been some strange type of noise from the sewers, so now we've had to all come back as adults to find out what's going on.
Yeah, that's
not a story to it. I'm not
joking. Yeah.
Cool. I'll tell you what then. just top level, nobles together, me and Cosimo together. I picked him up as a bounty hunter and decided to take him under my wing because he was down and out on his luck. And from there, we ended up being hired by the nobles to give them a bit of excitement into their life.
Yeah, to be like an escort as well, type of thing.
Like a bodyguard.
Yeah. You're taking us to see new things.
Yeah. Is that with you guys? Cool. Me and Cosimo being guides to you and your sister.
Sure.
Stepsister.
Making sure you don't do up stupid like picking fakes with our keeps.
I can take him.
I don't think he could. He would fuck you up.
Okay, I'm going to adjourn to my room for the night.
Yeah, me too.
Is he making a commotion, Phil?
The player sheet's gone funny.
Think I am yet. I don't think that's an option for me. No, not yet. Not until level 3. But yes, that's the angle I'm going to be taking. So, I move to investigate, Phil.
I'm just re-logging. What am I rolling for? My religion's plus one. What was the other one? Sorry, religion. My arcana's plus one as well.
They're all intelligence checks. Just roll an intelligence check.
And what dice are those, please?
So in your character sheet, you see where it says intelligence at the top. Mine's got, yours will have a 12 underneath it. Yeah, do that then. So yeah, click the word arcana and then roll. But it's the same for it. If for intelligence, you can click it and roll arcana, click and roll.
Yeah.
I move to intervene, Phil.
Finally, the party has started. I've been waiting for this.
What am I supposed to roll? I can't see initiative.
You know, it is on the top right, you know, you see those white symbols? Yeah? On your screen, top right?
No, I can see initiative and it says plus four and modifier plus zero.
No. Opening screen, top right, you have, you know, the chat. Next to it, it says combat tracker, the fist. Can you see it, top right of the screen?
You know where the compendium was?
Yeah, I've opened the fist thing.
Yep, okay. So it should be it should be not started and then a load of numbers.
And scroll down to your name and just click on it.
I think it's already done. Somebody else.
I clicked on it, nothing happened. It said 16.
Yeah, that's what we need. That's what we need. Your initiative is 16.
So I just roll a d20.
No, you already done it.
Okay.
By clicking on it, you already done it, you know, and you can see on the right hand side, you can see the order. There's an NPC, two NPCs with 20, you and me at 16, and the next guy is at 40.
Okay.
Yeah.
So this is the order that people are going to be, that they take their turns in now.
Oh, wait a minute. Can I do something?
Your turn, yeah, I would imagine so.
No, but wasn't there something that let me go first? That's what I meant.
What do you mean? I don't understand.
Yeah, but I don't think it was this one, was it? There was something that gave you, like, because he's quite weak. Okay, so I'm gonna wait for the person to take their turn, and then I'll take my turn.
No. We are doing turns, you know, according to the numbers. Can you see that combat tracker?
Yeah, I'm like third.
Yes. You're gonna be third to fourth, actually, third or fourth. But there are two other guys before us.
Yeah, that's cool.
You will see. Let's just do a combat turn, and you will understand it straight away.
Just something else as well. If you hover over the people or the names, so those numbers that you can see are people's names. They used to be monster names, but they gave too much away about while we were playing, so now they get randomized. So number two will be like common villager or something like that. So he goes first, and then it's Cosimo, and then it's you. But if you hover over it, you can see where you are on the map as well. It highlights them as uninjured. If you go up and down the list, so you can see where you are in comparison to everybody else. See that?
Yeah, I did. Thank you. So the person that's after me is the person that's gone and grubbed is Yarrick.
Yep.
Okay, that's cool. Yeah, I understand that. Cheers.
Okay, so you know this grubbing thing, did I notice that you know that dude grub? Okay.
He probably what?
Oh, that's not what I wanted to do. I wanted to do this. Yeah. Oh, it's too far for me. I can't reach to him. Shit. Why am I halfling? I should be a monk. So, I grab my loot and I will run, you know, so double movement, and I'm going I'm going here, so I try to be next to the guy who grabbed the other one, and I'm, you know, raising my loot, and I'm frozen in time. You know, I'm ready to strike in the next turn. And as a bonus action, I like to give bardic inspiration to this character, and I'm shouting it to him. Sorry, what's your character's name? Sorry, I can't remember.
Jalhhan.
Jalhhan. So I'm giving this, you know, bardic inspiration to Jalhhan. You shall remember this victory forever. And I give him bardic inspiration. You know what bardic inspiration is?
No.
Okay, so basically you have a d6 dice, and you can use it in the next 10 minutes anytime you want for an attack roll or a saving throw. Is there anything else you can use it for? Chat? I don't think so. Yeah. Check
ability as well. Checks and saving throws, isn't it?
Yeah. So basically, you can add a d6 to any roll in the next 10 minutes. So you have a almost hit, you know, you just add the d6 to it and, you know, roll. And if it succeeds, you hit. If not, no. Okay? So basically, I'm just helping you once in combat. That's what it does.
Okay, cool. Thank you.
Yeah.
You can do it.
Yeah, you will remember this victory for life. So, okay, I'm done. Thank you.
So, has he got this dude by the throat? Is he hurting this dude? I mean... how far can I make it? Can I make it across here? Can I attack him, or can I shoot him with an arrow from here? Well, why, we've just walked into this pub, so like everything that I've got equipped, I'd have on me, wouldn't I?
Yeah, but is your bow and arrow ready to fire? I mean, is the string attached and all this kind of thing?
Why would you have a bow and not have it strung?
No, you're not combat ready with it, you know.
You walk around with bow and arrow combat ready, but not ordinarily.
Oh, okay. But
anyway, it's... I mean, you can... You do kind of get one of them actions though, like unsheathing them. It's like, I don't know if knocking a boar's the same as unsheathing a weapon. Non-combat situation. No. Yeah.
So how far can I, how much distance can I do in one turn? It's like, can I run across here and then jump on the table and chop his arm off?
You can move 30 feet on normal movement, and you have an action and a bonus action after. Or you can double move, then you can move 60 feet. But you cannot do an action after. That's
you, see where your you see where your character is? If you hover over him and press control and then drag, you can start measuring out distances. Yeah? So it's just 30 feet now. That would be your movement to move 30 feet or 25 feet. Yeah? And I think, what's your character shape? So you can move 30 feet. Any round, you can break it up as much as you want. So you could move, attack, and then move again if you wanted to, but you can move 30 feet in the next 6 seconds. So each round is 6 seconds long.
Okay. Sorry,
each turn is 6 seconds.
It sounds like Jason's
okay. So you could move 30 feet there, or yeah. You could double move, which would make you let you move 60 feet, but that would you wouldn't have an action then.
What if I'm so? I'm not being pedantic. I'm just a question, right? So if I can go 60 feet, can I just run into him? Like, this is my route from here to here, and I'm literally just going to run straight through him.
Arch, is that a thing?
Because I can't really get close to him and do an attack because I haven't got a bow. Oh, wait a minute. How far do... It's like... Sorry, I took my finger off the bottom, Mike. So I can go 30, but then even if I'm here, I can't hit him with my sword, can
no,
I? Because
no.
You two are both in my way.
No, but and you cannot be next to it. You have to be next to it, and you know, you are actually 10 feet away, so you can't. You have to throw a dagger. Do you have a dagger?
Oh, wait a minute. I can run 30 feet, and then I can do an action.
Yeah. Yes.
Move 30 feet, yeah. And then do
action. You know, pick up a chair and throw it at him or something. Bar fight.
I was thinking of you.
Very, very funny. This is the small man joke. I heard this so many times before. You need to move on. It's not funny anymore.
Okay, I'm gonna move to here. How do I turn the tape measure off? It won't let me click it. It won't let me turn the thing off. I'm moving to here. That's where I am now.
Yeah, if you select your character, there you go.
There you go. Yep.
So, you know, this old man, is he injured at the moment or not? So he's not injured yet. Yeah, I understand, but that's what I mean. Is he injured yet or not? Okay, cool. Okay, yeah, cool, thank you.
Have you got a big beach, Phil? Let's have a look. I can zoom in.
Nice, friendly. You are killing me, man. I have minus one. Yeah, I have minus one. What are you doing to me, huh?
Is it an ability check or a saving throw?
Did I roll? No. Oh, I wanted. Sorry.
You can have mine if you want.
So how do I roll on? What do I have to click to roll on it? I can see the modifier, but how do I roll? I clicked on the modifier, nothing happened.
You won't, Phil. So on your character sheet where it says wisdom, just click the word wisdom, and it should pop a dialogue.
Okay. So I clicked all the numbers. The modifier, not the word. Okay, cool. So updated. Saving throw, you said, yeah?
It is, yeah.
Okay. Do I give myself advantage? No. Not this time.
Can I roll that?
Look what I rolled. With minus one. Yeah! I'm too stupid to understand.
That thing that Cosmo gave me. Can I roll that?
Yes, you can. Yes. Yeah, but you can have a d6 on top of your roll. But roll first because you might roll. No. You do your normal roll first and let. Oh, what? Listen. Okay, I don't think so. Even with the if you roll max on that, that's 6. I don't think so. A 9 would succeed. That would be a failure too. So I wouldn't have used it yet. But it's up to you.
It's cool. It's been done. Don't worry about it.
No, it's fine. I'm just trying to teach him how the system works. So I'm fighting it alone. Yes!
What does the level go up to, Phil, just so I can change your character sheet? Is it 7? Cool.
So,
I have a question on this. It's a technicality question. You said you cannot approach it. So is it possible to shoot at it from the distance? Okay. Yeah, asking for a friend, by the way. Okay, you heard it, guys, yeah? So I will be the melee character. I will beat it, and you just fire it from the distance. Cool.
Are we talking 5 feet or 10? Just semantics. Oops. At all? Scary.
I'm wondering if Charm Person works on it. I wanted to save him, that's why I asked if he's injured.
It's a bit redder.
I heard some kind of happiness in your voice. Some kind of pleasure. Dead.
Yeah.
How is he using a sword if he's now a tentacle monster? Okay, thank you.
Thing from 300 with like a mutated button on his shoulder. I can't move towards him. So, sorry, I'm just typing up what's happened so far. Right, here we go. Will that use my action, or is that just something I can do? Cool. Then I'm definitely going to try that. No, no, I appreciate it. Okay. What did Farzo do? Did he do anything? I thought he was before me. Oh, no, he's after me. Okay, cool. So, I'll just ask him if he... No, I won't. I'll not do that. I will move towards... Not allowed to move away from him, so try and get as close as possible. I'll move to here, Phil. And I will. Thank you.
I didn't think I had my bow on me. Okay then. Yeah. Yeah.
Fucking test my patience.
It's okay.
I will cast true strike on him, Phil, cantrip, and. I'll just point to him to you. And then let's meet him. Is there any beer on this table next to me? Because I'll have a quick swig. Yeah, that's definitely happening too. What the fuck is this? Glug, glug, glug. We're trying.
I bet you wish you gave me a flagon of ale now.
Steve, on that initiative tracker that we were talking about, I see there's a dice next to your name.
Yeah.
Yeah. If you click that rolls your initiative for this round. I don't know what happened last time.
Okay.
very nice.
Yeah, very good. That's not bad either.
Okay, so what do I have to roll to see if I can move towards him?
Or is it my turn?
Okay, can I want to, so can I draw my short sword and attack him? Okay, I've done that. Did that do it? Okay.
Do you understand why you missed, Steve?
Because it was on a 16 and it rolled to a 3.
No. Yeah, but the number 9, you see, you'll not know this character's armor class, but if you look at your character sheet, your armor class is 14. So when Phil's monsters are attacking you, if they get 14, is it 14 or less or 15?
No, 14 or more.
So it's 14 or more. So if your armor class is 14 or more, it hits you. So if that had an armor class of 9, you would have hit it. But its armor class is obviously higher, but you wouldn't know what it is. If that makes sense.
Okay, why is my armor class 15?
Because of the stuff you're wearing and your strength, dexterity.
Your dex modifier and the armor what you are wearing plus 10.
Yep.
Okay, is there nothing else I can do then at the minute?
No, not much.
That's your turn, don't go.
Are you a cleric?
No, I'm a fighter.
Okay, then no. I mean, maybe you can pick up something called defensive fighting style, which gives you +1 or something. I don't know. There's some ways to push it a little bit.
Okay.
You need better armor.
I think I need another hand axe as well, because I've only got one in my inventory.
No, there's two. But it just looks like it's one.
Okay, thank you.
I need to make another wisdom throw if I want to move forward, don't I? So I'll give that a try. So I'd rather crack him than throw some at him. Save it. Oh, we need James Salad. Does that work? 15? Lovely. So I will move to engage. I've got advantage on my attack. And I will crack in with a short sword. Yeah. second, so I'll roll damage, but I think I also get sneak attack as well. Plus there's people surrounding him. And it was I get sneak attack as well. Because I get advantage on my attack. As long as I'm not incapacitated, I get sneak attack on him.
No, no, if you have a ally. No, no, no. He got sneak
once
attack.
You can if deal damage to one creature with an attack if you would have had advantage on the attack. That's why I cast a cantrip on him to get the advantage. The attack must use a finesse or ranged weapon. And I also, as long as there's somebody within 5 feet of him, I get it as well, I think.
Yeah, so it's or, not and. So basically, if I'm fighting next to the guy, I'm next to it. Basically, he has got advantage. I'm sorry.
It's only once per turn. I get one
D6. You got sneak attack, regardless of that country.
Yeah.
Because I am occupying, I'm keeping that guy busy. That's what the rule says.
So that's 12 points of piercing damage.
I have a question. Are we playing by the rules of flanking in this game or not? Yeah, I know that. That's what I'm asking. So what's wise to do or not? If I move out, but if I move here, around, I can flank him.
Is that the downfall of flanking?
Yeah, I'm not moving out, I'm just moving around him.
Right, okay.
Okay.
I didn't know that either, but I'm glad that's been clarified.
I'm not glad because, all right.
At least we know now.
I do something else. So I will turn to Balak, and I give you Bardic Inspiration shouting this. Hang on, where I have it. Oh, you may die, but this is a sacrifice I'm willing to make. Okay, so you have Bardic Inspiration.
You're going to listen to these that he's going to start reading off from.
Yeah, I have a list saved. I always look for quotes and shit, I have like 50 of them saved for, all this thing and Vicious Mockery and all this shit.
Glorious.
I can't remember all this, man. But do you know where this is coming from?
No.
Shrek? Yeah. You remember when the guy is in the balcony and he's giving them the speech and he says, "You may die, but this is a sacrifice I'm willing to make."
Yeah.
You know, that king guy, that short one. Yeah. Okay, so after this, I like to I didn't work out how to use this in this character shit. So I am using Vicious Mockery on this monster, and I'm shouting at him, "What smells worse than a goblin? Oh yeah, you." So if you can do a wisdom saving throw, please, against 13. Yeah. Okay. So that's my plan when down in flames. That's a pass because it was 13. I cannot do what I wanted to do now. All right, I'll stand where I was standing and I cannot move, you know. All right, I'm done. Thank you. And I look at Balak. Do something!
Kayla screams every time it does. Ah! Yeah, 14.
Can I parry attacks that are not against me? Can I parry attacks that aren't against me? Yeah, I've got parry, but if that dude's attacking him, can't I parry him?
What does parrying mean work? What's the wording? Yes. It's you. Yeah, it works only on you. Paladin has got the ability like that. Yeah, in intervention, yes, that's it. It's a feat or something. Told you, you may die.
It won't be a Cthulhu adventure if somebody didn't die. I'm only unconscious.
Yet.
It is a flesh wound. I'm dead. Zero. It didn't do more than double, so I'm just on zero. Unconscious.
Yeah, but not yet, in the beginning of his turn.
It's on my turn. Oh, fuck off.
Me? What are you doing, man? How can I save you, huh? You're unconscious. You should roll with disadvantage.
Never mind. Just a normal one, isn't it? I don't know what that means. I'm same, I've never died before.
So there's a 10. So this is 10 and it's a d20 roll. Yeah,
So,
but you can use your constitution modifier, isn't it? No?
I've just rolled. Yes, that it is. I just rolled a. No, just I did a death saving throw that was just on the sheet. I rolled a 12, and it were a 12.
Okay, so it's not. Okay.
But if it is, it's something that's on this one. That's me. No, three death saves unless I get healed.
Yeah, you have to roll three successful ones.
Has it been that long since you've had a character killed, Phil? And monks, isn't it?
Okay, Cosimo is casting Healing Word on Balak. You don't like me, do you? For fuck's sake, whatever I do. Oh, for sake. Whatever. Okay? Hang on. No, let me think about this. Okay, I'll do it in a different way. Let's see if it works. I like to cast Vicious Mockery on this fucking bastard. If you can do a DC 13 Wisdom saving throw, please. Let's see if this time he fails it, hopefully. I told you don't like me. Okay. All right. Fine. What do I have to do? So I'm casting Healing Word. So you have an attack on me. Thank you. Sure. Okay. So I think I. Okay, so when I'm trying to cast it, it says I have no level spell slot, but I do have two of them, so why don't I have one? Do I have to modify it by hand? Write two on it? Hang on, it let me, because I manually over-everything it. So healing... So 6 points of healing to you, Balak.
It should. One had it done, I think.
And after this, I'm pounding my chest.
Okay, I've only got an amount of hit points, and that's yeah.
So I'm pounding my chest. You know, hit me, bite me.
Oh yes.
Listen, guys, he might like me.
Do something.
Hang on. After this, I like to do something because he used his opportunity attack, isn't it?
Yeah, he's used his reaction.
Oh, I'm moving away. Bye bye. I'm hiding behind the table and I'm getting my range weapon ready. I'm done. Thank you.
I need to roll something first still, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, I don't have to do the wisdom roll thing.
Okay, then.
I'm going to attack him with my short sword. I'm going to try and chop his arm off.
Approach.
she'll sit and read with you.
Yeah.
Oh. Awesome.
And okay, nice one.
You get plus two as well because of your fighter ability.
Okay.
I've just been reading your attacks. Does it? Okay.
Do I do damage now?
Yeah. And it's added the plus two. Fantastic.
Oh, that's nice. That's going to help me. Okay, then. Hasn't what?
Six is two and four, so... So it's plus another four, so it's 16 to hit. Because it's the first dice, isn't it, that's maxed. So it's 16.
We need to burn it.
Is it dead?
We need to burn it. There's a fireplace there. I'm shouting from behind it.
Can I check it first? Check its body?
Are you looking for treasure?
No, I want to... Well, yeah, but I want to make sure it's dead. But, like, I want to check its... the clothes that it had on when it was in the form of a human to see if there's any type of idea why it just turned into Mr. Tentacle Face and we had to chop it to pieces. Okay, I'm going to take that and then I'm going to throw it to Farzo. For the damages, and then let's chuck him in the fire then, Cosmo. Pardon? Sorry, you broke up a bit then, I missed that. Well, firstly, not selling flagons to people that want them.
We'll ask him if there's an appropriate place to dispose of this madness.
Cosmo, get a refund for the money you paid for before.
Why?
He just said everything's free and you paid when we came in. You've already paid for the rooms.
Listen, but I'm a gentleman. I don't want a refund. I'll take for free whatever he says, you know. I look for his best drink, and I drink it out, drink him dry. But I'm not asking for a refund.
I'll approach the bar, Phil, and I'll ask him for the strongest drink he's got. Just initiating a conversation. What the fuck is going on around here? Fantastic. Make it a double. I'm the nerd. hammers, nail it, and just...
I ask him, is this your finest drink as well, or is it only the strongest? Okay, do you have more? Okay. I drink like I never drunk before. I mean, like a thirsting sour. So we are just thirsty after this hard work. So food-wise, maybe you can pack up something for us in the morning when we leave. We'd appreciate that. I mean, sorry, I'm a little bit confused. What I meant when we leave, okay? Up to that point, you know, if you can, enlighten us with some drinks, I would really appreciate that for my companions as well. And find me someone to play dice, please.
Is this kind of occurrence been happening recently, or is this something that's... I'm just trying to get the frequency of... Has this happened before? What about in the surrounding area?
What about the moors? Then drink with us and tell us your gossip.
Azo.
Fonzie, way. Ooh, that's interesting.
Saying there is a backwater like this, though, you seem to be doing quite well for yourself in this establishment.
To where?
It's a moment of sanity, Phil. Is that the nearest?
We're not from around here. Yeah, them us Northerners just kicked that tentacle monster's ass. Can I come out and stand on the balcony?
I think the third gate is going to be right outside.
who the proper authorities be?
What do you mean by who knows? Okay. Sounds interesting. Do you have more drinks? I drink until I don't know about much myself. Free drink. And it's the memories to forget in my head.
I think it might be bedtime, little man.
Sure, drag me up. Carry me up like, you know, a bride. Please, thank you. Or just leave me here on the floor. Whatever. You choose. I'm easy. Easy maintenance.
Thank him for his saving words today.
You mean me?
Yeah, you.
Oh, okay. Do I recognize any of this, or am I beyond that level already?
I waited until you were past that to tell you.
Hey, don't go outside. There's another one of those big monsters.
Where? Oh, I'm sorry, I'm passed out. Fuck, I can't do this. No.
What's through this door, Farzo?
Just give it.
Can I go into your kitchen? Because I like to look at architecture. What are these dudes hiding here for?
Yeah.
I don't know where people go to sleep at night.
Where's our bed? Can we show us to our room so that we can get some rest? Okay, I'm confused. How has it gone from being like a cesspit to having a really nice bedroom?
The local area is not very nice, but this pub, for some reason, on the main trade route, is actually quite prosperous.
I mean, if you remember, Phil said it is like an oasis in a desert.
In a desert, yeah.
So it's much better than the surrounding area.
Okay, cool. What time are we going to tonight?
It's about time to cut.
Okay, cool.
And we are playing in 2 weeks' time, if I remember. Yeah, because the next week I'm in York, and I mean, I might have internet in the hotel, might not, I don't know. Do you want me to let you know if I can play or not? Okay, I'll check internet in the afternoon and I'll message you guys, okay?
Did Garrick have a bed up here? Has he got some? Oh, cool. Shall we search for his belongings then? Have you got a floor plan for upstairs?
I think any tokens on the scene, Phil, can't see.
Yeah, you can see what you can see.
How do you feel, Cosimo?
I'm fine. Why? You know, you are
old, giant.
You are all the guys, you know, who run away, you know, scared of this monster. I was the only one standing there. Yeah. I'm a brave warrior.
What? Do we find anything as belongings, Phil?
Can I check that dagger? I mean, sorry, I'm actually drunk like hell. No, sorry, someone else, not me. Sorry, I just remember that. Okay.
We'll make a note in case any of important. So, snares, dagger.
We need a wizard in this campaign. All this magic item hall, what we're gonna encounter, we won't be able to identify.
What we need, healer.
Oh, fine, that's good, I like it.
Yeah, she's the Red Witch.
But listen, did you understand my inside joke regarding all this hall of magic items? Very unlucky. Yeah, cool. Thank you, guys.
Cheers. Thank you.
I liked it very much. Thank you. Bye-bye.